So this video is to explain clutches, what their function is, and how they work. So a clutch is located between the engine and the transmission, and the purpose of a clutch is to act as a linkage between the engine and the transmission, so that you can take the rotating power from the engine, pass it to the transmission, and to the driven wheels. Now it may look complicated at first, but it really isn't that bad, so I'm going to try and describe it as best I can. First, I'm just going to go over all the components involved. You've got the flywheel here, which is connected to the engine, so that's going to be rotating. Connected to the flywheel is this clutch cover here in red. And within the clutch cover, you've got the clutch disc that's here in green. You've got a pressure plate in blue. And you've got a diaphragm spring. And here is what you're actually going to be moving with your foot. When you push in that clutch pedal, you're going to be moving this release bearing. And then you've got the output shaft. Now, one thing to keep in mind when you're looking at this, everything is rotating with the flywheel except for this green disc right here, the clutch disc, and the output shaft. Everything else is going to be rotating with the flywheel. It's all connected. So what happens is, when you push in that clutch pedal, you disengage the clutch. It's going to look like this. You're going to pull that blue pressure plate off of the clutch disc, which is squeezing the clutch disc between the flywheel and the pressure plate so that they rotate at the same speed. So here's what it looks like when you let go of your clutch pedal. It's going to squeeze the pressure plate onto the flywheel. The clutch is going to be in between, sandwiched in there, and this is the output shaft, which is going to your transmission. It's going to be forced to rotate at the same speed that the blue and black here are rotating, the flywheel and the pressure plate. So how does it release then from the clutch? Well, when you push in the clutch pedal, it forces this release bearing right here against this diaphragm spring, this red diaphragm spring, which with these little bolts right here, it acts as a pivot point, and it pulls this blue pressure plate away from the clutch. So it's going to act as a pivot point here, and when it presses in here, it's going to go like that and pull this blue pressure plate off of the clutch. The clutch is going to be free to spin just in the air, and so that's what's going to be connected to your wheels. That green there is that output shaft. This diaphragm spring, it's kind of difficult to see what it actually looks like with just a straight line. What it actually looks like is this here, and what happens is you've got these holes here. They're actually more circular than I drew, but you've got these holes here, and these are where your bolts are going to be connected in. See, your bolt is going to go in each one of these holes, and so when you have your release bearing push against that diaphragm, it's going to be pushing right here. And as it pushes against that, it's going to force the pressure plate off, and the clutch can then spin freely. So once again, just a little review of what's happening is you're going to be pushing this release bearing in, and it's going to cause this diaphragm to kind of bow in like that. And as it bows in, it's going to pull this pressure plate up off of the clutch disc so that they can rotate freely.